Hi, my name is Tony. I am a very nervous person by heart. One morning, an alert popped up in my mobile saying a big bank collapsed overnight. Though it was shocking, I felt safe because all my money was in a different bank. After a while, I thought, what if my bank collapses too? I dashed to the bank next morning and withdrawn all my money and kept it at home. This made me feel safe. Next day, I started to worry again. What if the money is stolen? I dashed to my workshop. I opened it and made a special glass box with a lock. The box is unbreakable, and nobody can open the box ever without a key. Felt safe again. After a few days, I woke up with the news that the Fed is printing money to provide a stimulus package. In other words, authorities are printing money and injecting into the economy. If more money is printed, this means more supply of currency, which naturally means less value for the money I have in my glass box. Meaning, my money in the glass box values less, though the glass box remained unopened. This made me feel annoyed and got me to thinking, how can I solve this? I'm determined to create a currency which is not controlled by authorities and which I can keep safely locked with me. I made several glass boxes. I have given a unique number to each glass box. I went to my workshop and made 21 million coins. Poured all these coins into a heap in a deep anonymous wonderland. I handed out anonymous flyers with four rules. Anyone can get glass box for free. They can put money in that box. They can throw the glass box into the anonymous wonderland. Everyone can see the glass box and how much money is there inside. Anyone can deposit money into the box, but no one can see who that box belongs to and no one can open the box. Only the one with the key can open the box as the only owner has the key to open it. The key is safe in owner's pocket. Some people will need to be recruited. Job of these people is to keep an eye on the glass boxes and make note of every transaction. That is, if Alice opens the glass box, takes the money out and pushes it into Bob's glass box, they'll then write it on a piece of paper saying, reduce the money from Alice's box and add it to Bob's box. That's hard work. To make the people writing these transactions happy, Alice, the one who opened the glass box, will pay a teeny tiny amount of money to the person recording the transaction. Alongside Alice, these people will also be paid from the big pile of 21 million coins in the Wonderland. Anyone can come and record the transactions, but each time only one person will be paid. This person is picked using a lottery style mechanism. Everyone writing down the transactions will be handed over a puzzle. Whoever solves the puzzle first will get paid. This is a special puzzle which needs brute force to solve rather than intelligence. I opened an anonymous WhatsApp group to answer questions. There are several questions I got. I'll tell you the most popular ones. How can I pay for the groceries with that money?
The grocery owner must have the glass box. You can take money from your glass box and deposit it in the owner's glass box.
What if I lose key to the glass box?
Nobody, including me, can open or break the glass box. So if you lose your key, you will lose your money. It is similar to losing your iPhone in a fish market. But I think it's better than losing value for your money without your fault, that is, banks collapsing or authorities printing currency.
What if you run out of your pile of 21 million coins? Will you add more to pay people writing transactions?
No. It's capped. No one, including myself, can change anything in the Wonderland. The Wonderland is immutable. But don't worry. For about every 100 million transactions, the payments I make to the miners is halved. This way, for all the pile to run out, it will take at least up to the year 2140.
Oh, wait! So after the year 2140, people recording the transactions won't be paid? Then who will watch our transactions?
Recall. People recording the transactions, alongside being paid from the pile or also paid by the person who opened the box to make the payment. So they will still receive that teeny tiny transaction fee.
But if it's tiny, for the people recording the transactions to solve puzzles, they will need to spend a lot of energy. Why will anyone want to do all that work for very less money, for the teeny tiny money?
We are talking about the year 2140. As the money paid to the people recording the transactions is halved every 4 years, the supply of the Bitcoin will diminish. Less supply means more demand, meaning price will increase. By the year 2140, the price of the currency should be in tune of billions. So the fee Alice pays, which is 0.0001 coin, should be enough to attract people recording the transactions.
But you are dealing with money, people's money. What about government regulations?
Rules and regulations are for the people and the organizations. There is no person or organization running this machine. I am not a person. I am a thought.
What's your name?
Sathoshi Nakamoto.
Thanks for staying with me.
This is a fictional story I've narrated to my mom and my 10-year-old to help them understand Bitcoin.
The new currency in the story is Bitcoin. This is digital currency. The unique number given to the glass boxes are Bitcoin addresses. The key in your pocket is private key.
The anonymous immutable wonderland where all the glass boxes are kept is called the blockchain.
Alice opening the box, taking the money out and depositing it in another box is peer-to-peer transfer because it's directly transferred from one person to another without any bank accounts for either of them through a fully digital transaction. The fee Alice pays to the people recording the transactions is called the transaction fee.
People who are recording the transactions and solving the puzzles are called the miners.
The record of transactions being noted by the miners is called the distributed ledger. That is, several identical copies are distributed among many people. The mechanism, the miners trying to solve the puzzle and register the transaction in the ledger, is called proof of work.
Thank you.